Good morning, Facebook! It's Tuesday, which for most of my life since I was like 9 or 10 years old has been probably the worst day of the week, but I don't feel like that's the case any longer. I think Wednesday is now the worst day of the week because for the last 3 weeks, Wednesday has been the worst, last week being easily the worst of those three Wednesdays. But the good news is I am trying to reframe my attitude and only focus on the positive. So we don't have to deal with a bad day potentially until tomorrow, and maybe if I approach it with the attitude that it's not gonna be a bad day, then it won't. Maybe that negativity manifests itself from inside me. So there's my little Zen nugget of wisdom before we take some bites out of Billy's bowl and chew on the daily dish. Let's get dishing.
Billy the Kid has your dish. It's the Daily Dish.
As far as confirming Kylie Jenner's pregnancy, at this point I'd say it's a given, but the Kardashian family still isn't willing to go that far. In fact, yesterday morning on Live with Kelly and Ryan, Ryan Seacrest got a message from Kris Jenner live on the air that said, "Kylie is not confirming anything." If you're not familiar with the history, Ryan Seacrest basically jump-started the Kardashian brand himself, so I don't know if that makes him more or less reliable when it comes to these kind of things. What we do know when it comes to the Kardashian family, well, not exactly the family, but people associated with them. Scott Disick and Sophia Richie went to dinner on Saturday night and received a cake that said, "Congratulations, Scott and Sophia," on it. You really only think of two options when it comes to something like that: engagement or pregnancy. The sources say they're not engaged, so could there be a baby on the way? Scott Disick has children with Kourtney Kardashian, so maybe just that simple fact is enough to tie him to the family and force him to sandbag that announcement until they can squeeze as much press as possible out of the Kylie Jenner pregnancy. I'm just saying. So there are three actors named Chris in the Marvel Universe. Chris Evans, who plays Captain America, Chris Hemsworth, who plays Thor, and Chris Pratt, who plays Peter Quill / Star-Lord in Guardians of the Galaxy. They're all pretty much universally regarded as really good-looking guys, and there are quizzes you can take online to find out which Chris you are. So Chris Pratt took one of those quizzes, and naturally the result he got was Chris Evans. He tweeted a screenshot of the results with the caption, "Dude, I suck at quizzes." And then the real Chris Evans quote-tweeted that, saying, "What do you mean? You aced it." Now we just need him and Chris Hemsworth to tell us which Chris they are. Maybe it'll be a trifecta of displaced personalities. It always makes me happy to hear news about flat earthers, and the more ridiculous it is, the better. B.O.B. is one of the most famous people who very vocally believes the earth is flat, but he's willing to reconsider for the right price. He started a GoFundMe page to raise $200,000 to, quote, "launch one, if not multiple, satellites as far into space as he can." In the 5 days since the campaign's been up, he's raised $581. Somehow I don't think he's going to reach his goal. But the question is, does B.O.B. really believe the Earth is flat, or has he been playing us all along? He hasn't been very relevant in quite some time, even though he's been pretty consistently putting out music, so maybe this whole flat Earth shtick is just an act to get us to pay attention to him? I mean, it's been working. I find it fascinating. But maybe that still wasn't driving up his sales, and now he needs some quick cash. The best part of this is he's moving forward trying to launch satellites to prove that the Earth is round, as though no one has ever sent satellites into space before, or somehow the ones that have launched are not trustworthy and only B.O.B.-approved satellites are reliable sources. This whole thing cracks me up.
Well, Billy the Kid in the morning, next.
Whee! So, what we're going to do is, we're going to do Mac to School after 9. That's pretty much, we're going to talk about some Halloween costumes here in a second, most popular Halloween costumes of the year. We're going to do Mac to School after 9, and other than that, pretty chill morning. Got the Bill and Scott Cubicle Show coming up in exactly 2 hours and 51 minutes, so 10:30. Eastern time, because as we say every day on the show, that's the only time zone that matters. If you're not in the Eastern time zone and you're watching this, I'm sorry, you need to move because your time zone is no good. So anyway, as always, thanks for watching, thanks for listening, thanks for tuning in, and I will see you. Oh, I gotta take this call, so I'm gonna take this call, and we'll see you for the Cubicle Show. Until then, peace be with you.